turning to John chapter 8. And if you need a Bible, go ahead and raise your hand and we'll get that passed out to you. And if you don't have a Bible, the Bible that gets passed out to you, you are more than welcome to make that a source for yourself, pretty much, to have that relationship with the Lord, to get to know Him. It's His Word. I highly recommend it. I read out of the New King James Version, and so if you guys are reading out another version and you get lost, that's why, because I'm New King James. I used to study and read King James, but it's just no one understands me when I talk that way. I'm like, thou shalt do it, and then what? So, with your Bibles, turn to John chapter 8. We're going verse by verse and chapter by chapter through the Bible, pretty much. So far, we've been in the book of John, and we haven't been able to get out of it. There's just so much jam-packed there that to study and to absorb God's Word. And so it's my heart not to rush through it, but rather just give what the Lord wants. And if the Lord's putting on my heart a certain area, thing to talk about, then we're going to just stay there.
Amen.
So John chapter 8, and I think it's awesome that we can gather together. As we were praying earlier, I invite you guys, if you guys would like to pray, it's not just a leader thing. I guess I wanted it to be just leaders, but if it's the Lord, it's a prayer meeting. So if you want to be a part of the church and just come alongside our prayers and what the Lord is doing here, we meet in the, I don't know which room it is, but the third room over in the back by the coffee lobby area. We meet about, let's say it's 10 o'clock, we're going to start meeting about 10 o'clock. James could head that up just in case I'm late. And we're just going to keep praying and praying. So we need that, and prayer is a necessity. Also, worship's a necessity. As I were praying in the prayer meeting, the Lord put it on my heart about this whole technology stuff that we have. And you guys, the early church just survived without technology. We don't need PowerPoint. We don't need a video camera or even this mic thing. It's all luxury. And so just it's an extra blessing to have it, but our faith is not in it. Our hearts are not in it. And so we need to continue to worship the Lord despite these technology things. They're always going to give problems. That computer in the back's always been giving me problems. So I have learned not to trust in that thing. So, cool. With your Bibles open, let's go ahead and pray, and we will continue. Jesus, we thank you that you've brought us here, that you have led us here to hear your word, not to come and hear a pastor teach, Father, but rather to hear you and your word and what it says to us. And may I hear from you, Lord, and give out what you say. May your Holy Spirit be upon us and continue to walk us through your word. And may we fear you, God, with a godly fear. And may we continue to trust in you in all of our ways, that we might not doubt the things that come our ways that are from you, but rather walk by faith, Lord, even though we don't see it. And I pray right here that you would grant us boldness as you had, and as you refuted these Pharisees and these scribes, Lord, as they came at you in anger. May we walk in love with each other, rebuke one another if there is a rebuking to happen, but may there be restoration, may it be done rightly. And so may you continue to press upon our hearts the truth of your word, and not our word, but your word. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, so John chapter 8. Last week, we were just talking a little bit about the difference about who are you? Some people question, who am I? And today I just want to talk about, well, really, who do you stand for? Everybody's going to stand for something and someone. And for those of you who call yourself Christians, if you are a Christian, you got to have an understanding of what you're standing for. You see, this Friday I was talking to a pastor, youth pastor, who believes Genesis chapter 1 is poetic, meaning it didn't really happen. It's just, you know, something they put there to sound good, and it's just, you know, I believe God created everything, but it doesn't really mean God created it in one day, you know, then 2 days and 3 days and 6 days and the seventh day God rested. It just means that God, you know, was in action, but it doesn't mean a day. It could have meant a millions of years and millions of years. And you see, with that thinking, you have a problem here. You don't really believe God is the I Am. Because if you believe that God is the great I Am, then you believe that God can create things in one day. You will believe that God can speak things into existence. If you do not believe the magnificent, pretty much power of God, then you're not going to believe His word. You see, you can live a Christian life, right, and come to church and be a good person, but if you don't believe in the person of God, well, then your life is really hypocritical, meaning you're living a life that's not really what it seems to be. The word hypocrite comes from the word, it's almost like Hollywood pictures, right? You see an actor who's acting a role of who he's not, but he's doing it for the sake of the movie, but that's not who he is. Romeo really wasn't Romeo, you know what I'm saying? He's a person, and after the film is off, he's that other person. You get what I'm saying? And as Christians, we need to be one person. Amen. We can't live a two-doubled life style. We can't say, hey, I love Jesus, and then go and do the things that counter, the things that contradict God's word and what Jesus requires of us. And that's why I love going through this passage right here, is because it kind of puts us back into check. If you're like me, I have the tendency to drift into certain areas, certain ways and certain things. And if I'm not on a firm foundation, and if I'm not standing for something, well, I'm going to go through different waves and different, you get what I'm saying? And that's why God's word is so important, because this is going to be the foundation of everything. We're going to run into the I Am statement once again about Jesus. And just to go over some quick little things about last week's study, look at verse 37 of John chapter 8. It says, this is Jesus speaking, and he says, I know that you are Abraham's descendants, but you seek to kill me because my word has no place in you. See, God makes a clear distinction that, yes, you guys came from Abraham's fleshly seed, right? You came from Abraham's seed, but he also says in verse 39, here's a clear difference right here. He says, they answered and said to him, Abraham is our father. Jesus said to them, if you were Abraham's children, you would do the works of Abraham. So he says, yes, you're of his flesh, but you're not of his, you're not the spiritual children of Abraham. And if you guys want to know more of that context, you guys can read Galatians. It's kind of committed to explaining about Abraham in that area. But it's about being in the spirit. It's not about being in the flesh. So, in other words, you are not going to heaven because you have the same blood line lineage of Abraham. You're not going to go to heaven because of that. It's not because of, while you are a good person, you went to all this schooling and you learned this stuff and you have this title. So therefore, it makes me allowed in heaven. That doesn't say it in the Bible. You guys get what I'm saying? I've been doing this to you guys like crazy the last couple weeks. Is what I'm trying to do is teach you and train you, stand on God's word and never stand on man's word. Yeah. You see, we have, as a church, we have our traditions. We have our ways, and those are good. I'm not against a lot of the traditions that we do. For instance, I stand up, you sit down, we come together in this room alone. There's a lots of ways that we do stuff, but it's just tradition. It never said in the Bible that I had to stand up, and you guys get what I'm saying? Yeah. We have traditions, but it always comes down to God's word. Traditions never save anybody. And religion that we know of today is a lot of works-based.